Starbucks is in a coffee shop. That's a great to have an experience where you sit in like you read a paper, you meet some of those people, you get free Wi-Fi. The coffee's actually just a transaction. So it's part of the experience. It's part of the experience that creates engagement and transactions.
I'm covering all finance, so I'll just pose a lot more questions rather than sometimes.
Thank you.
We've had a great discussion. There's lots of other examples of people doing similar things. So there's great intelligence and skill in the room, including people like Miranda Pennell, who did something called the Human Radio, where she would ask people who dances in their house, in their homes, find out who said yes, and then film them dancing in their homes, make that happen. But moving into outdoors, someone came up with a really good idea, which was kind of just really clear and obvious to narrow it down, but it was inspiring, was if you're building on the community, and you're building on the community site specific in architecture within that community, so you build on the stories which are based not only in outdoor space, but based in the history of the buildings of that outdoor space. That kind of seems to kind of pull two things together for us.
We looked quite a bit about what it takes to get permission to do things in public space, whether that's publicly owned public space or privately owned public space. And sometimes you have to be quite big or wide rich to be able to see those permissions through. So sometimes the option is to go guerrilla because you can do it cheaper and quicker and ask for forgiveness afterwards rather than make permission. We also had a quite contentious discussion about the fact that maybe a shopping mall isn't the enemy, but it's the perfect public space. But it's where people are, it's where there's a connection to the home park street, the shopping mall, cars go out every day, back and forth. And so maybe there's an opportunity there to create new audiences, to go where the kind of bustle is, and to create a kind of a democratising influence in a kind of commercial environment by giving people something that isn't paid for, rather than the isolated kind of cultural environments that we've talked about earlier. We can get back to the death on that one. We talked about whether or not artists then have to become comfortable being salespeople and becoming business.
Kind of drew a circle pretty much early on return on investment in terms of the arts. And someone, I think it was Jardy, said, well, look, it's pretty important point Roger was saying earlier. Arts as a voice were on the table right from the beginning. But there was this kind of then notion that might be fine in its early days, but basically what happens later on is that those things change, that companies might have that written into their ethos or their objectives in terms of commercial companies, but they get bought and sold, and other people come in and just want to make an investment, and the value of art rapidly diminishes. So the point here about aligning incentives and motivations between artists, art, organisations and clients. So I think that comes back with understanding the language of what developers are wanting to do and trying to perhaps understand what their thoughts are in terms of and being able to sort of put into a common language so that if it's football, you can understand and say to developers, we can bring in 20,000 people or social media, which is a massive thing within, for example, shopping centres at the moment, but we have an online presence of, which is fine, or 700,000, that kind of thing. But there's a point there, I think again from Jardy, which is to do with, do we want, will this corrupt art by us doing that, how to think of arts in those kind of terms, that terminology. So we picked up on that, and the finishing point was actually all things change. All things must change.
So we're going to have a Q&A after that. So I will collect after break all the questions and try and select them so there's no repetition so we can guide the Q&A afterwards. So we start again at 1:45 there, which is in 10 minutes, and please write some questions for the panelists.
Thank you.